Hey, today I'm going to show you how to create a Team Fortress 2 Classic server. I will be following this tutorial right here on the PDF that you can find at Team Fortress 2 Classic Discord server. And we are going to follow this mostly Slavic. So the first thing you want to do is to download both Steam CMD and Team Fortress 2 Classic. After you've done this, we are going to start with setting up a folder in order to install this install CMD, Steam CMD and Team Fortress 2. What we first do then is make a folder. It doesn't matter where you place it, if you place it on your C drive or whatever. I'm going to place it on my desktop, and I'm going to call it TF2 Classic. All right, let's open this up. All right, I also in downloaded already both TF2 class Team Fortress 2 Classic and the Steam CMD. What I'm going to do, I'm going to create two folders right here. I'm going to call the first one Steam CMD and the second one SDK 2014. All right. So we will start by extracting the Steam CMD file to the Steam CMD and just start that up. All right, it's downloaded and installed. What we now need to do is go ahead and make a batch file. We're going to call that what it says here, like just create a TF2 classic.txt. Just paste what it says here. We don't really need to do anything. Special about that. Oh yeah, I jumped over ahead here. So let's start script, we call it. We'll just call this start script.bat. Oh, if you haven't configured how to so that you see the file types behind your file, you can go into let's see. Yeah, you can go here, press file right here, options, view. And then you see here hidden files and folders and show hidden files and folders. If you don't do that, you will have to like go into your notepad or whatever, and you have to save it as, and then you have to save it as a batch file. And then you have to change like this, you know? Or you actually don't have to write it like bats, but yeah, whatever. You have to change it, you have to save it like that, or else you won't be able to run it. So I have a start. Let's see. Start script bat file. I'm going to edit that in my notepad right here. I'm going to paste in this right here, which is steam cmd plus run script tf2classic.txt. All right, so this is kind of a crucial point. We are going to go ahead and also copy the next file and paste that next text or script and paste it in the tf2classic.txt. This is a crucial part because I see that there's some people that actually misunderstood what they should do here. And I actually did that the first time as well. You have to put the right destination directory for this to work. If you don't put the right directory in this force install.dir value, you will do it wrong and you will have an error when you start up the server. So what I will do, I will go into my server directory and I'll just paste this and paste it right. Copy it and paste it, of course. Yeah. All right. So when I've done that, and I've done that for both of those steps, I will go ahead and press start script bat. So what this will do is it will now start downloading everything it needs. To the SDK 2013. All right, so now the SDK 2013 is downloaded. Now we have to, let's see, we have already done this step. Yeah, we already done that as well. Yeah, so now we have to go to the CFE folder of, yeah, actually, we did actually mess a step here. So I didn't extract the TF2. Let's see. I didn't extract the TF2 classic to this map, to this folder. So that's also a thing. You have to extract the TF2 classic to your SDK 2013 folder. And also, you can just call SDK 2014 whatever you want. That doesn't really matter, as long as you have done it in your folder or in the file, the TF2 classic file. All right, I've also extracted that now. So we will go ahead and go to the CFG file, folder I mean. Here we're going to create this server.cfg. I think actually I have it. Yes, I have that. I'm going to just put that right there. So this is the CFG that I have. And in it, I've actually just called it TFT Classic Server. I'm not sure. Yeah, it's actually the standard. Yeah, it's nothing changed here. So I have created a server.cfg and placed it in the CFG folder on the TFT Classic folder. And we're going to skip this. Just remember, just copy and paste that into a file and you should be good to go. The next step is to make a batch file for your server so that you can start up the server. You do this by doing the same thing you did last time. We're going to call it start server. We are going to have a bat behind it. Oops, sorry for that. Right there. Then we're going to open it with our notepad. Okay, and then we're just going to paste what it says here. It doesn't really matter. All right, so here you can change the start map, and you can also change the max players. For instance, also, by the way, to change settings for your server, you are using this, what we just created last time. We just change the values here or add values, whichever you want. It doesn't really matter. It's fine to start the server with just the default and just adding and changing after your whatever you want, really. And also, you should actually change the value of your max player here as well as in that bat file I just showed. So this start file, yeah. After that, you can just go and start the server with your bat file. So there will be some arrows maybe coming here, or that it says that it doesn't find something, but it will actually just generate whatever file it is. If you actually get some arrows here, you should be checking that, and that you can ask us at the TF2 Classic Discord if there's any problems. So I hope you enjoyed this little video. I hope I didn't do too many mistakes here. And if it's any confusing, you can just contact us at the Team Fortress 2 Classic Discord server. I will put everything you need in the description below, as well as the PDF I'm working on right here. There is going to be a Google Doc file that one of our people at the server is actually working on. So